presented the corrigenda, and the corrigenda corrects some errors and makes some movements in the budget. But the key item is the adjustment of the resource envelope arising from the expected additional revenue from taxes and also the external financing, which had not been confirmed at the time when we presented the budget, amounting to 716 billion.
As the end of the second session of the 11th Parliament draws near, Parliament is in final touches to pass the 2023-2024 financial year budget before the end of next week. This week, the Ministry of Finance bounced with a corrigenda to the budget, which revised the 2023-2024 budget upward from 50.9 trillion to almost 52 trillion. But members of Parliament dubbed the spike unrealistic, given low revenue collections reported by URA.
2 trillion budget. Me, as a person of experience in research, looking at the trend, is not realistic. We shall not raise that money. But what we can do is to identify those priorities that are likely to generate more money to the economy, and we put money
here on our overborrowed money over time. And the moment you take away the borrowed money, it leaves you with a miserable small quantity of discretionary expenditure for service delivery.
The last minute additional revenue benefited the Bank of Uganda, which was allocated extra 254 billion towards financing government liabilities to Central Bank, Ministry of Tourism, Wildlife and Antiquities, which revised more than 33.3 billion among agencies. In the same line, the budget committee summoned Bank of Uganda officials to appear and explain the state of national reserves after registering reservation with the increased indebtedness of government to the central bank.
I think 250 billion will go to settle the indebtedness at the central bank. Then there is also another additional 250 billion, which was already presented in the draft estimate.
Now they are adding 250. The question that we want to know is the extent of our liability to Bank of Uganda.
This week, Parliament dedicated the entire Tuesday to mourn and pay special tribute to one of their own, retired Colonel Charles Engola, the former Minister of Labour and Employment, who was shot dead recently by his bodyguard, Private Wilson Sabiti. The body was laid instead for public viewing. Wreaths were laid on the casket. Words were spoken. Memories were recited. Praises were made as legislators bid farewell to their colleague.
Express a displeasure with the unfortunate practice in this country where people celebrate the misfortune of those they don't agree with. Engola answered the highest call of serving his country as a professional soldier.
Next week, the House is expected to pass the budget ahead of State of Nation Address and the budget speech.